Welcome back to Unguarded, where I am thrilled to be joined now by NHL Commissioner Gary Bettman. Gary, welcome.
It's great to be with you.
The longest tenured commissioner of all the North American sports. And pretty soon, when Bud Selig retires in January, I understand you will now be the oldest.
Well, thank
as
you
well,
for that. Thank you.
But
thank
only
you.
62. We got to point that out. I mention it because it's a real accomplishment to be the senior man among this group of men. Is this how you always envisioned yourself?
If you had these visions when you were younger, they would institutionalize you. There was no way to predict where we would be today, but it's been a lot of fun, and I'm looking forward to the fact that I think even the best for the NHL is ahead.
Now, do you and Selig and NBA Commissioner Adam Silver and the NFL's Roger Goodell, do you have secret meetings? Do you have secret handshake? Is there anything
we should? No, nothing like that. We periodically talk to each other, say hi, see how we're doing in either particularly good or stressful times. But there's no regular structure. There's no secret clubhouse.
Now, NBA Commissioner Adam Silver did make a little bit of a splash this week. He wrote an op-ed in the New York Times talking about legalizing sports gambling. He advocated for that pretty strongly. What do you think?
I think there needs some attention to be paid to what sport is going to represent to young people. Should it be viewed in the competitive, team-oriented sense that it is now, or does it become a vehicle for betting, which may, in effect, change the atmosphere in the stadiums and the arenas?
Do you think that it would change the nature of sports?
I think it could. Do you want people at football and basketball games rooting for the spread or rooting for their favorite team?
And there are some folks building an arena in Las Vegas, the gambling capital of the world, and they've talked about wanting an NHL team there.
So I've heard.
Yes. So what do you think about that?
The good news for us is the NHL's never been stronger, never been more popular, and that, I guess, has led to a lot of interest being expressed from a number of places on interest in getting an expansion team, and Las Vegas happens to be one of those places.
All right. I mentioned Roger Goodell. Certainly, he has been the subject of much scrutiny since things exploded in the NFL over the summer. Have you spoken to him since that time?
Briefly, we were at a conference together.
What did you guys talk about when you did meet up?
I asked how he was doing, and he said fine, but we didn't get substantive on the issues of the day. With respect to the issue of domestic violence, we've been providing counseling and education, both through our security department and our behavioral health counselors, for over a decade.
You did have a player, though, from the LA Kings arrested just last month. Now,
yes.
He hasn't played since.
Correct.
What went into your decision to keep him off the ice?
We decided that with everything that was pending, the most prudent, sensible, appropriate course of conduct was to suspend him until things could be sorted out through the judicial process.
It does seem you're also evolving on the Olympic Games. What is your biggest concern with having NHL players in the Olympics?
Well, actually, the issues aren't new, and that is to stop the season. Football's gone. There's no baseball yet. It's just us and basketball. We're getting ready for the stretch drive, and then we stop. The other issue is, some NHL teams will send 10 players to the Olympics. Some will send two, and those teams will come back in different conditions than when they left.
Injuries, well-rested or not.
You have it. And so there's a competitive aspect as well, and it's something that it's not all good, it's not all bad, it's a balancing act.
Do you have a sense yet whether NHL players will be in the next Winter
Olympics? We haven't focused on it.
All right, so what are your goals for the NHL going forward?
We want to continue to grow the game at all levels, particularly at the grassroots level, and internationally. Whether or not we do another Olympics, we are focused on bringing back a World Cup, and that's something we're working on with the Players Association.
What about you? How much longer do you want to do this?
As long as the owners are happy and I continue to be energized, we'll keep doing it.
Well, we're glad you're sticking around. Thanks for coming here today.
Great to be with you. Thank you.